Please select Training, Mission, or Explorer mode.
Come in, ISS. Mission Control here. Now that you know the layout of the station and how to move in space, you're ready to go to work. Proceed to the Destiny module. We'd like to explain the laboratory in more detail. Proceed to the Destiny module. We'd like to explain the laboratory in more detail. Destiny is the primary module for U.S. payloads, where most research is done. It supports a wide range of studies and accommodates 24 equipment racks for control of ISS systems and science experiments. Take a look around. See if you can find the exercise bike and the emergency medical table. Used in the Destiny module is called the glove box. Find it now. One of the critical tools used in the Destiny module is called the glove box. Find it now.
Laboratory. Again, this is a laboratory with science experience on all of the walls here, all sorts of stuff that we do. And one of the things we also do is we exercise. We have some exercise equipment on board the space station. We need to do that because we lose bone density and muscle mass while we're up here, and that's a result of not having to fight against gravity. So, how we keep ourselves in shape are with a bike, a tread.
One of the critical tools used in the Destiny module is called the glove box. Find it now.
So all you need to do is actually clip your feet in, and then you can start pedaling. You don't need a seat, because you don't sit down. Actually, I haven't sat down for 6 months now, so you don't need any type of seat. Just make sure you're held in with your pedals. You probably see that the bike bounces around a little bit. As I move it, it's not steady and held to the wall firmly. And the reason for that is the space station is pretty big. You saw that there's also solar arrays on the space station. If we start putting any forces into the space station, it's going to make those solar arrays bounce around a little bit. So to prevent that, the machines bounce around a little bit, move around a little bit, and that way we don't put any forces onto the structure of the spacecraft out to the solar arrays.
The glove box is a secure unit in which experiments can be done in a safe, quarantined environment. The ISS is due to receive new experiments to use in the glove box on a resupply mission arriving soon. You can also access a number of archival videos showing previous experiments. See what you can find. Mission Control to ISS. Please go to Node 3 for capsule docking. I say again, please go to Node 3 for capsule docking. Use your tablet to see where Node 3 is located. When you have the map up, you'll be able to select any module by pointing and touching it with your right index finger, and you'll immediately go there. Whether you use your hand controls or are selected on the tablet, proceed to Node 3. Go ahead and continue to Node 3. The name of Node 3 is Tranquility. This is where oxygen generation, carbon dioxide removal, and water recovery is done on the ISS. If you haven't found it already, look around for the cupola. Depending on how you're oriented, you can probably find it below you. Without gravity, you can rotate yourself and turn head over heels to make yourself upside down relative to the station. Press up on your right thumbstick to rotate until the cupola is over your head. Then move yourself up and inside. The cupola is every astronaut's favorite location on the ISS because it has such a fantastic view of the Earth. Take a moment to see what home looks like from 250 miles above the surface. This is also a great spot to watch approaching spacecraft. We have an unmanned resupply mission ready to dock at the station. You'll need to commence manual docking. Initiate the docking procedure from your tablet by tapping on your selection with your finger. Approach the controls and we'll guide you through the procedure. Now that you're at the controls, you'll see monitors showing the view from your external cameras. The joysticks in front of you will control the Remote Manipulator System, or RMS, which is the main robotic arm. The RMS is attached to a platform called the Mobile Base System, or MBS. The translational joystick can move straight in any direction. In and out, left and right, up and down. You should be able to see both the capsule and the capture port on two monitors. Try moving the joysticks and see how the robotic arm responds. Use the translational joystick on the left and the rotational joystick on the right to bring the arm into position.
Abort ISS, abort.
Your controls are locked up. We'll reboot them from here. Give us a minute.